infirmity among the people. Our opening hymn this morning is 478. Receipt. And to let you know, the Lenten money, the funds that used to be raised through the Lenten cards used to go to the Synod office for their ministry. Well, they've written to us this year, and the Lenten cards, the money that is raised through the Lenten cards, is going to stay in our parish this year for the ministry that we're doing. So I really want us to be active in our Lenten cards as well. This week, I just want to mention a few of our things that are happening. Bible study at the rectory. We were packed in, I think there was 13, Sheila, there last week? There was 13 of us, and Phyllis was missing, so she's going to be there this week. So there's going to be 14 of us this week, and see how you were all cold there all of a sudden, right? So please feel free to come out. We are studying the stories of the Old Testament, and we're doing the story of Noah this week, so you can prepare in advance. And you can read the story of Noah, and then we're going to come and we're going to talk about the story of Noah. The rest of your announcements are there. I know that there is a meeting that was put in the bulletin, yeah. Wrong.
Wednesday instead of Thursday for the youth and family life.
Wednesday instead of Thursday for the youth and family life. All right. So can I have the children please come forward?
Come on!
How are you this morning? Oh, that's wonderful. Now, and how are you this morning? Well, we have the bed. Sit down. There we go. Such a pretty dress. I like your dress. All right, let's see what's in the bag this morning. Oh, I know what these are. Oh, that's...
sunglasses.
I just came to say I love you. I just had to do it. You know what I'm saying? Sunglasses. What are sunglasses for? To protect your eyes from the sun. I like this. What else is sunglasses for?
So you don't damage your eye.
What else is sunglasses for? What else is sunglasses for?
Looking cool.
Looking cool. Thank you. I know eventually they were going to get there because I look cool. So do I look cool in the sunglasses? They're not quite sure, I just want you to know. They're not quite sure, right? Okay, so everyone together, do I look cool in the sunglasses?
Yeah, maybe.
Oh, I'm getting a maybe in there. Okay, I'm going to do it one more time. You know the proper answer now. Okay, does Reverend Travers look cool in the sunglasses?
Yeah.
There we go. You guys are awesome. Nicholas, can you help me up? Get up here. Aww. All right, boys and girls. If I was, you know, I just thought of a song. Yeah, never mind. Oh yeah, I will. Yeah, I gotta do it. There was a song when I was your age. It was a Vacation Bible School song. I think I can do it. As I was walking in the woods one day, I met a great big polka dot bear. Smile in his eye and a twinkle in his... smile on his face and twinkle in his eye, and a porcupine cone in his hair. And just like God loves you and me, I know he loves his bears. No, that was from Vacation Bible School when I was your age. Okay, so... I want to ask you, if I was to use sunglasses, Nathan, you gotta help me out here. If I was to use sunglasses to say something about Jesus to someone, what would I say?
Jesus, the sunglasses block out the sun. Jesus blocks out the bad.
Okay, that's it. You know what? We want to hear this. Come on over.
Because it'd be nervous.
The sunglasses block out the sun, and Jesus blocks out the bat.
That's awesome. What she's saying is Jesus protects us from the bat. and he certainly does protect us. Because, yeah, can you answer the because? Ah, that's right. Because he loves us, and he loves you very, very much. Can you raise your hands with me? Raise them way up in the air. Raise them way up in the air. And we're going to go one, two, three. Dear Jesus, thank you for today, for all our fun at work and play. Thank you that you protect us and you love us. Amen. That was absolutely fantastic. Now, have you ever begged one? So, you'll get it next week. You remind me. You can get the stick this week. Could I have the sunglasses back? Because I've got to return those to the, who had the bag this week? There we go. Boys and girls, can I have? Can you go grab one of the sticks as well? Thank you, Nathan. You got to grab it. Grab a stick, man. All right, boys and girls, you may go out to Sunday school. While the Sunday school is heading out to go downstairs, could I have the congregation please stand with me? Jesus will not be defeated. Jesus gives us confidence for friendships. Jesus is the strong foundation. Jesus is our light in the darkness. Together, Almighty God, by grace alone, you call us to accept us in your service. Strengthen us by your Spirit, that make us worthy of your power. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated for the proclamation of our word.
This lesson is taken from Isaiah chapter 9, verses 1 to 4. There will be no gloom for those who were in anguish. The land of the tribes of Zebulun and Naphtali was once disgraced, but the future will bring honor to the region. From the Mediterranean eastward to the land on the other side of the Jordan, even to Galilee itself, where the foreigners live. The people who have walked in darkness have seen a great light. They lived in a land of shadows, but now light is shining on them. You have given them great joy, Lord. You have made them happy. They rejoice in what you have done, as people rejoice when they harvest grain or when they divide their wealth. For you have broken the yoke that burdened them and the rod that beat their shoulders. You have defeated the nation that oppressed and exploited your people, just as you defeated the army of Midian long ago. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Psalm 27, you'll find in the service book on page 735. Psalm 27, page 735. We'll read this psalm responsively by the half verse. Please stand. After verse 1, we'll go to verse 5. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom then shall I fear?
The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid?
One thing have I asked of the Lord. One thing I seek.
That I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life.
To behold the fair beauty of the Lord.
And to see in his temple.
For in the day of trouble he shall keep me safe in his shelter.
He shall hide me in the safety of his throne, and set my eyes on the rock.
Even now he lifts up my head. Therefore I will offer in his dwelling an oblation with sounds of great gladness.
I will sing and make music to the Lord.
Hearken to my voice, O Lord, when I call.
Have mercy on me and answer me.
You speak in my heart and say, seek my face.
Your face, Lord, will I seek.
Hide not your face from me.
Nor turn away your servant in displeasure.
You have been my helper, cast me not away.
Do not forsake me, O God, of my salvation.
Though my father and my mother forsake me,
the Lord will sustain me.
Show me your way, O Lord.
Lead me in the path because of my enemies.
And now together, faithful God, you shall be all who hope in you. May those who seek your face be set free from fear and distress, and come to see your goodness in the land of the living, through Jesus Christ, our light and our salvation. Amen.
Second reading is taken from 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verses 10 to 18. I appeal to you, brothers, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, that all of you who agree with one another, so that there may be no divisions among you, and that you may be perfectly united in mind and thought. My brothers, some from Chloe's household have informed me that there are quarrels among you. What I mean is this. One of you says, I follow Paul. Another says, I follow Apollos. Another, I follow Cephas. Still another, I follow Christ. Is Christ divided? Was Paul crucified for you? Were you baptized into the name of Paul? I am thankful that I did not baptize any of you except Crispus and Caius. So no one can say that you were baptized into my name. Yes, I also baptized the household of Stephanus. Beyond that, I don't remember if I baptized anyone else. For Christ did not send me to be baptized, but to preach the gospel, not with words of human wisdom, lest the cross of Christ be emptied of its power. For the message of the cross is foolishness to those who are perishing, but to us who are being saved, it is the power of God, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our gradual hymn is 96.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew. Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Now, when Jesus heard that John had been arrested, he withdrew to Galilee. He left Nazareth and made his home in Capernaum by the sea, in the territory of Zebulun and Naphtali, so that what had been spoken through the prophet Isaiah might be fulfilled. Land of Zebulun, land of Naphtali, on the road by the sea across the Jordan, Galilee of the Gentiles. The people who sat in darkness have seen a great light, and for those who sat in the region in shadow of death, light has dawned. From this time Jesus began to proclaim, "Repent, for the kingdom of heaven has come near." As he walked by the Sea of Galilee, he saw two brothers, Simon, who is called Peter, and Andrew, his brother, casting a net into the sea, for they were fishermen. And he said to them, "Follow me, and I will make you fish for people." Immediately they left their nets and followed him. As he went from there, he saw two other brothers, James, son of Zebedee, and his brother John, in the boat with their father Zebedee, mending their nets. And he called them. Immediately they left the boat and their father and followed him. Jesus went throughout Galilee, teaching in their synagogues and proclaiming the good news of the kingdom and curing every disease and every sickness among the people. The Gospel of Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Let us pray. May the words of my mouth, the meditations of our hearts be acceptable to you, O Lord, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. If I was to ask you what was the greatest experience you've ever had in your entire life, I wonder what you would say. Just a second, I want to look at my choir when I say that too. If I was to ask you what was the greatest experience you've ever had, hands down the best of the bestest, what would you say? I wonder what you would say. I bet some would say, the birth of my children. How many are on that page? Birth of my children. How many would say birth of grandchildren? Oh, absolutely. When our children are born and they come and they make that experience just so awesome and so profound. Some might have, okay, this is a good one to ask. I want to look, I want to try to see everybody with this. Okay, how many people would say their wedding day? Okay. Wow. Wow. Or not even you. I don't know. Okay. That's all right. You know what? We do have very special experiences of incredible days. Indeed, I remember each of my children, those moments, and their eyes opening for the very first time in this world. And I got to scare the living daylights right out of them because they were looking at me. And I remember those moments and singing to them and praying over them in that moment, asking God to bless them. You know what? One of my very first prayers were for my children. After I thanked God for them and blessed them for all the days of their life, I said, "God, I know that you are going to prepare her for someone special, and I know that you're preparing someone special for her." I was still in the delivery room when I was praying that prayer. These special moments, incredible moments. I was in I was fishing. I was about 15, 16 years old. I still remember this moment. As we went into this lake called Clearwater Lake, We were driving uphill most of the way, and what it was is this lake was an extinct volcano, and there were some really nice trout, big fat trout, brookies in there, you would call them. And oh, what a wonderful, and we decided because it was going to be a full night, we were going to stay out, my buddy and I were going to stay out and fish most of the night because we want the fish in the moonlight as well. And I want you to know a harvest moon came up that night. The water was as still as glass and the orange as reddish orange as it could ever be. And that moment, what an experience. What an experience in that moment. The twinkling of the stars and the lake and on the water, and you could hear the pin drop and nothing but the crickets and frogs all around the place. What a beautiful moment. It was not just a moment in time, but it was an experience. An experience. I'll tell you, he's some talkative today. It was a real experience that, you know, we've all had that. And we come to our gospel today, and the reason why I mentioned all of this stuff was we come to our gospel today because there is an experience in our gospel that we're invited to. We're invited to. Jesus began his ministry with this: repent, for the kingdom of heaven is near you. See, we think of the kingdom of heaven as a destination of a place where we're going. How many think of the kingdom of heaven as a destination, a place where you're going? Oh, this is all right. Well, if you put your hand up, you're absolutely wrong. Absolutely wrong. I'll tell you why. Let's go back. You've heard me say this before, maybe. In the Lord's Prayer, thy kingdom. When is that for?
Now. Now.
When is that for?
Now.
When is that for? Now. That's for now. The kingdom stuff is for now. Heaven is that land that is fairer than day. That place that we go to is on the other side of the Jordan. We sing all of these wonderful songs. And that is that place that, you know, Jesus said to the thief on the cross, that today you will be with me in paradise. But repent, for the kingdom of God is near you, is a state of being, of life, that we are to be experiencing when? Oh, church, come on, are you awake this morning with me? Church, when are you experiencing it?
Now.
It's for now. When we are praying over people and people are being healed and being blessed, or God's presence is being made fully known for them, that's the kingdom of heaven now. When our children are taking 40 minutes to close out youth group because they're praying for other young people to be healed, I'm telling you, that's kingdom stuff when?
Yeah.
Now. That's kingdom stuff now. And we've got to recognize that this is an experience that he brings us into. And I want you to know that there is power in this experience. Did you know that you have power? You have power. All the power of heaven and earth that has been given to Jesus has been given to you and I to allocate his blessings to every one we meet. We are their experience of Jesus Christ in this world, for we are his ambassadors, his representation, his reflection in this world. And when Jesus called those disciples, there was something about that moment of time that they went with him. They said, oh, just a second, I've got to check the chicken on in the pot. Oh, the fish is on. I gotta check the fish. Oh, you know what? I've what's that one from the scriptures? I've married a wife. I've bought me a cow. I have fields and commitments that cost a pretty sum. Pray help me. Excuse, I cannot come. That used to be an old song that the kids used to love to sing in the 80s at camps. And they'd switch around the words on me every once in a while. And you know what they would say? I have married a cow and bought me a wife. What can I say? That's kids. That's part of that experience as well. Mint Brook Camp is that experience as well. Being a grandparent for the very first time, that's an experience as well, isn't it? Could you wipe the smile off your face? And the glow in your heart? Ooh, I gotta tell you, I'm having an experience right now with my oldest daughter. You see, her boyfriend at Christmas time came into my office and he said, Reverend Trevor, sir, may I talk to you for just a moment, sir? And he talked about how much he loved my daughter and how much she loved him. And he said, may I have your blessing to ask her to marry me? Well, I gotta say, I'm a big sookie when it comes to my kids. I just want you to know. And the tears came up in my eyes. And I gave Reuben a hug and I told him, of course. After I gave him a hard time for a little while, I just wanted to know. You know, I've got to be me, you know. And we're experiencing right now, I had a call and she said, Dad, can you look at these rings? And she texted me a whole bunch of pictures. She said, which one do you like? I said, I don't know, which one do you like? And we had this conversation and then she phoned me back again and guess what she said? He's ordered the ring, Dad. Oh, he's ordered the ring. This was an experience, folks. I could feel the shine and the glow and the joy and the excitement coming through her cell phone into my cell phone, and the glow was all over me. Her excitement, it was such an experience. Our gospel is about that experience of now. That kingdom of heaven stuff now. God invites us to display His kingdom. Oh, isn't it wonderful? His kingdom now. And His kingdom has a foundation that is based on a four-letter word. Does anybody know that four-letter word?
Love.
Love. The foundation of the kingdom of God here on earth is its foundation on love. And Hebrews says it very well. God is love. And it's an experience that He invites us to. And when He called His disciples, they did not have an excuse. The word says, immediately they left. Immediately they followed. And they followed after Christ. You are called to the experience today of following Jesus Christ. Amen? Let us pray. Father, we give you grateful thanks that our experience of your kingdom is the foundation of love in this world. May we love this world that we're living in and love those people that we see all around us. May we love them with the love of Jesus Christ within our hearts. Amen. Let us stand together and we affirm our faith as we say the faith of our baptism. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Please be seated for the prayers of the people.
For the prayers of the people, we'll use litany number 7 on page 116. Litany number 7 on page 116. Let us pray. For Justin, our Archbishop, Fred, our Primate, Percy, our Metropolitan, John, our Bishop, and Francis of South Sudan, Robin, our Priest, Sheila, our Deacon, and those who minister in our parish. In the Anglican cycle of prayer, we pray for Lake Rukwa, Tanzania, the Right Reverend Matteo Casagara. In the provincial cycle of prayer, we pray for the Diocese of Fredericton, Bishop David Edwards. We pray for the parishes preparing for their annual meetings. We pray for all lay people called to new leadership in their congregations. We pray for safe travel on winter roads. And we give thanks for the parish and congregational committees that have served over the past year. In the Tridiocesan cycle of prayer, we pray for the parish of Belargent, awaiting appointment, congregations at St. Hilda, Belargent, St. Mary Harbor Mill, St. Paul, Jack Fontaine, St. Thomas, Grand Lapierre, St. Mark, Main Harbor, the Ascension, Brookside, the Transfiguration, Boat Harbor, St. Peter, English Harbor East. We pray also for the parish of Bay of Islands, priest in charge, the Reverend David Taylor, St. John's, Lark Harbor, St. Ambrose, John's Beach. For the Church of the Living God throughout the world, let us ask the riches of His grace.
Lord, may have
mercy. Yoke, burden, bar across our shoulders, rod, oppressor. Jesus is my light and salvation. Whom shall I fear? Thank you, Heavenly Father, for the message of the cross, which is foolishness to those who are perishing. But to us who are being saved, it is the power of God. Gentiles, darkness, great light. Repent, for the kingdom of God has come near. Thank you for our repentance and our ability to be with you. Jesus said, "Follow me, I will make you fish for people." The actions of Jesus, teaching, proclaiming the good news, curing disease and sickness among the people, Thank you, Heavenly Father, for the opportunity to do that as we experience your kingdom here and now, and we are your people working for you. For all who proclaim the word of truth, let us ask the infinite wisdom of Christ. For all who have consecrated their lives to the kingdom of God and are struggling to follow the way of Christ, let us ask for the gifts of the Spirit. For our Elizabeth, our Queen, for Justin, our Prime Minister, for Dwight, our Premier, for Fraser, our Mayor, and for all who govern the nations, that they may strive for justice and peace, let us ask the strength of the Lord. For scholars and research workers and their studies, that their studies may benefit humanity, let us ask the light of the Lord. Heavenly Father, we bring to you the needs of Larry, Amelia, Rita, Matt, Donna, Nettie, Lloyd and Mary, Blaine, Wes, Ann, Leroy, Kelly, Jerry. Those we name now. Those we name in our hearts, and those known only to you. For all who have passed from this life in faith and obedience, let us ask the peace of Christ.
On page 191, dear friends in Christ, God is steadfast in love.
Infinite in mercy, he welcomes sinners and invites them to his table. Let us confess our sins, confident in God's forgiveness. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole hearts. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Would you please stand with me? The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Would you share the peace of Christ with those around you? Our obituary hymn is 387. gift is found in your bulletin. Loving God, before the world began, you call us. Make holy all we offer you this day. Strengthen us in our calling. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ the Lord. Amen. On page 193, the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right that we should praise you, gracious God, for you created all things. You formed us in your own image, male and female. You created us. When we turned away from you in sin, you did not cease to care for us, but opened a path of salvation to all people. You made a covenant with Israel. Through your servant Abraham and Sarah, gave the promise of blessing to all nations. Through Moses, you led your people from bondage into freedom. Through the prophets, you renew your promises of salvation. Therefore, with them and with all your saints who have served you in every age, we give thanks and raise our voices to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. I invite you to be seated. Holy God, source of life and goodness, all creation rightly gives you praise. In fullness of time, you sent your Son, Jesus Christ, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He healed the sick. He ate and drank with outcasts and sinners. He opened the eyes of the blind and proclaimed the good news of your kingdom to the poor and those in need. In all things, he fulfilled your gracious will. On the night he freely gave himself to death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take and eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Gracious God, his perfect sacrifice destroyed the power of sin and death. By raising him to life, you give us life forevermore. Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Recalling his death, proclaiming his resurrection, and looking for his coming again in glory, we offer you, Father, this bread and this cup. Send your Holy Spirit upon us and upon these gifts, that all who eat and drink at this table may be one body and one holy people. A living sacrifice in Jesus Christ, your Lord, our Lord. Through Christ, with Christ, and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Breaking of the bread, sentence 2. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ.
We eat and drink our body, for we all share in one bread.
The gifts of God are given for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Amen. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven.
The body of Christ, the bread of heaven. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven.
Oh, rainfully sing.
is over.
Our service begins.